Hi again. Welcome to another 5-minute tip. So in this tip, we're going to look at the fracture object with MoGraph dynamics again, except this time we're going to look at explosions. So this should be fun. I figured out this tip when messing around with the object and one of my motorcycle models. I have the bike here in a scene, and what I did was I wanted to see if the fracture object would buckle under the pressure of all of the individual objects that exist in this model. So what I did is I put all of the objects, I took all the objects out of hierarchy, and then I put them in a fracture object and I ran a dynamic simulation on it. The result I got was kind of astonishing. When I pressed play, the entire machine exploded. It looked really cool. But for a split second there, I was thinking to myself, well, why did that happen? And I'm just going to explain to you guys really quickly how that happened and how you can use it as an effect. I have a file here with 3 cubes and a floor, nothing else. So I'll just create a fracture object, put the 3 cubes into it, make the floor a collider body, and then to the fracture object, add a rigid body tag. If I press play, they should fall to the floor and stay there. That's completely expected. But something interesting happens if the cubes intersect each other even a little bit. Some of you guys might be onto the solution already. So if I make the cubes intersect each other a little bit and then I press play, they all sort of push each other away. And this is because of the self-collisions that a dynamics object has on it by default. For instance, if I were to go back to my bike and on the dynamics tab, I go to the dynamics tag, I go to collision, turn off self collisions, and press play, that's kind of what you expected to happen in the first place. Everything would just sort of fall down by itself. But essentially, with self-collisions turned on, if an object intersects another object even a little bit, it explodes and it creates a really cool effect. Now, what if we wanted to control that effect? We wanted to control the explosion, force the explosion to go in one direction instead of another. We can actually do that quite easily. MoGraph objects are influenced by effectors. We don't have an effector that'll let us explode something in a certain direction, but we do have particle modifiers that allow us to do that. And it turns out that particle modifiers can be used in dynamics tags force tabs. So here in the force, we have a list of forces that we can either exclude or include. So I'm going to change it to include, and then we can go to our simulate menu under particles, and we can get an attractor. So this attractor object has been around for quite a long time, and it's going to be difficult to see what it does, but it attracts particles towards it. So it doesn't seem like it's doing much here because the value is probably too low. But if I change the strength to 5,000, before doing any of this, I actually need to add it to the force list. You can see things are starting to be pulled towards it. So we added the attractor and things are being pulled towards it, and it's kind of a funny chaotic result. But we can actually use the attractor before the explosion happens to blow the motorcycle in a certain direction. So right now it's to the front and the side a little bit, so it would pull objects towards it in that direction. But if we go to the attractor settings and we change it to negative 5,000, it sort of does the inverse of attraction, which is repulsion. And so if we press play now, it actually repels things away in that direction. And you can animate that value. So if we wanted the motorcycle to seem like it was being exploded from behind, we just put the attractor behind with the big negative value. And then we can sort of predict that the motorcycle is going to explode forward. And again, you can animate that value so that it sort of peaks really suddenly and then drops off. You can put the attractor object above the bike and it sort of squashes it towards the floor. prevents it from blowing up into the air too high. You can put it right underneath, and as you'd expect, it sort of launches everything into the air. So that's a really interesting use of the fracture object with MoDynamics. You can sort of control which direction an explosion happens in. Just by using an attractor force with a negative value, it becomes sort of a repulsor force. And you can have small values like negative 500. It has less of an effect. Or you can use a really big value like negative 10,000 and it's really catastrophic. So if I just press play, you can see it's a really strong force. But to keep it realistic, like I said, you'll want to animate the force so that it's really strong for about one or two frames and then it goes back down to zero. So I hope you enjoyed this tip and I hope you get to use this to blow some stuff up in one of your projects pretty soon. So until next time, see you.